We solicited some questions from Twitter and from Facebook.
From my campaign Twitter page?
No, just from our Twitter followers.
I'm kidding. You wouldn't be going for my campaign.
Mark wants to know, how do you plan to grow jobs and small businesses in New Mexico? Second part of his question is interesting, too. He wants to know, will you put your business in a blind trust?
Well, I can answer the first question, the second question first, and the answer would be yes or sell it. And I have had people who've wanted to buy my company over the years.
You would sell it, you say?
Yeah, I mean, that's an option. In my state, my company doesn't do any lobbying. We have very little business with government. And so, I mean, there are no conflicts of interest that I can see. But nonetheless, it would be in a blind trust. I wouldn't be able to run my company and run the state at the same time. I haven't been able to run my company and run for governor. I haven't been to work in 10 months. But, you know, I am a small business person, and I have created my small business in this state from nothing. And I think the state needs to do more to support small businesses. You know, we create all these great tax credits to incentivize large companies to come in from out of state, Fidelity, Hewlett-Packard, et cetera, et cetera. Why are we not doing the same for the little guy? The guy who goes out and mortgages his house, who works 18 hours a day to make a great idea successful for himself or herself and their families. Why are we not providing those same kinds of tax credits and incentives to all the small businesses? You know, we have lost 46,000 jobs in this state in the last 18 months. If every small business in New Mexico were to hire one person, we wouldn't have an unemployment problem. And so we need to sort of redirect a lot of our energy to the people who are in New Mexico, not because it's a great place to do business, because it's a great place to live, and make it a good place to do business for small companies. I'd like to see New Mexico as the startup capital of the United States. You know, where we incentivize these companies to come here, invest money, and take a shot at building, you know, a great company. That's what I'd like to do.
We've got another question here from Facebook, and Sophie wants to know, when are you going negative? Someone's got a break.
Well, I committed a long time ago. In fact, I think I was the only candidate to put it in writing that I was not going to go negative. I don't think it does any good for candidates. I certainly don't think it does anything for the debate. So that's going to have to be someone else who does that.
You're out.
You know what? If I get through this campaign and have not gone negative and lose and can look at myself in the mirror knowing that I talked about the issues that were important to me and I did what I felt was right, that's okay with me. But I am asking myself the same question. When is someone going to go negative?